So, it's time to change your cap and air filter, and instead of having someone do it for you, you decided to go the DIY route, replace it yourself, and save some money. That's great, except you run into one problem. In the process of taking out that old filter, and you're about to put in the new one, you look on your filter and notice there's an arrow, and usually it even says airflow direction. How do you know which way the air is going to flow? Sometimes you get really lucky and you end up with a weird shaped cabin filter that only fits in there one way, and it's kind of hard to mess that up. But if you end up with something like this, and it's a rectangle that looks the same all the different ways that you twist it, how do you tell which way the air flows so you can at least point that arrow in the right direction? First off, that arrow doesn't even matter. Well, it does. The cabin air filter is built specifically to have air flow through it one direction. The holes in the material are bigger on the side where the air is coming in because it wants to capture all the big stuff first, and then it gets smaller and smaller depending on how many layers are in your particular filter, and it's designed to catch the smallest stuff at the end of the filter and the larger stuff at the beginning. That way, it doesn't clog up very quickly. If you have it flipped around the wrong way, that does still filter out everything that it would otherwise, but you end up with a clogged filter far sooner than if you had put it in the right direction. With that being said, how do you find the correct direction to point this filter? Well, when you took the filter out, there's usually a door or panel that you have to flip down or remove, and on that you may find molded into the plastic an arrow or something else saying this is the direction that the air flows. If you can't find anything like that, fortunately there's another way to find out which way the air is flowing. This is a blower motor. Don't worry, you won't have to remove one of these, this is just to show you what it looks like. Whenever you turn your AC on and the fan starts blowing, this is the fan. These are smaller examples of a blower and a fan. Luckily, we don't have one of these fans because the blower is much more easy to tell where the air is going to flow. With a fan, sometimes it's hard to tell just which way the air is going to flow out of it. Some of them are actually designed to go both ways, but with a blower, it's only going to go one direction. With a blower, air is going to come in on the inside of the fan and out on the outside of the fan. Back to our automotive blower, air is going to come into the inside and then out of the outside. So if there's no labeling telling you which direction the air is going to flow, when you pull out your cabin air filter, look inside where it came from and see if you can find a blower. Normally it's going to be at the bottom, but it could be located at the top. So if you're looking in through a panel and you can see the blades of the fan here, you want to put your cabin air filter in so that arrow points down. Air is going to be coming in through here, through the top of this filter, into the fan, out the side. If you have a cabin air filter or two located underneath the plastic where your wiper blades are, where the window meets the hood, then unless there's some obvious design difference, the filter is going to sit in there with the arrow pointing down because that's the outside air being pulled in through the filter into your cabin. Hopefully this video made replacing your cabin air filter a little easier, and if you learned something and you want to learn more, consider checking out my channel Car Simplified. I've got a whole bunch of automotive topics that I cover, and I hope to see you in the next Car Simplified video. Thanks for watching.